about the chordate phyla. Yesterday we discussed about what are the basic structures we should consider if you want to decide whether the animal is a chordate or non-chordate, whether it belongs to vertebrata or invertebrata. So as a part of the series of the chordate phylum, yesterday I had given you the classification also. It is broadly divided into anatha and natostomata. Anatha means those who are not having the jaws. That means they will have a jaw, but it is not made up of a bony material. Okay, in that anatha we are having a special class, that is cyclostomata. So before the fishes, these are the animals, cyclostomata. After this we will see what is the classification of fishes and what are the different classes which are present in the fishes. They do not have limbs, they are having fins. So we will see some of the characters and some of the examples of the class cyclostomata. So these are all the animals which are present in the cyclostomata are ectoparasites on some fishes. So what are ectoparasites? If this is a fish, this cyclostomes is present on, it will stick on the outside of the body of, outer surface of the body of a fish. So that is ectoparasite, that is present outside the surface of the body. So all the animals belongs to the class cyclostomata are ectoparasites. Body is elongated with 6 to 15 pairs of gill slits. Most high number of gill slits are present in this class. So these are helpful for respiration. And these mouth parts are sucking type. For example, this is the body and if this is the mouth, it is circular, but it is having a sucking like material because it is sucking the food materials. So this is a sucking type of mouth. Suckers will be there. Sucking and circular mouths. Already I told that without jaw. So that's why these are called as anatha. Division anatha. Okay. And in this animals, scales are absent. Paired fins are absent. So what are scales? If you eat a fish, first of all we will remove some plate like materials, some scales. So outer skin, that is scales. In the cyclostomes the scales are absent. And here cranium, that means it is also known as brain box, the bony material which is helpful for the protection of brain. That means if it is a brain, the cranium is a bony material which will protect the brain. So cranium and the vertebral column, that means backbone, vertebral column, here is cartilaginous. That means it is not made up of bone, it is made up of cartilage, that is soft material. And here the circulatory system is closed type. And what is the specialty in the cyclostomes? These cyclostomes are mostly belongs to marine. That is in the seawater. But for breeding purpose, for laying eggs, for example, they will come for fresh water. This process is known as spawning, that means laying of eggs is spawning, and moving from marine to freshwater is migration. Migration. Understanding? That means here we have to remember one thing. Moving from marine to freshwater, this is known as anadromous. This term is very important. Anadromous type of migration. That means from marine to freshwater. And here they will, mothers will lay the eggs, and after laying egg, mother will die. And this larval forms, the egg develops into larva, and that larva again they will go to marine waters. So this term, freshwater to marine water, this is known as catadromous. Catadromous migration. See here, again I am explaining. Cyclostomes are completely, they belong to marine. But the mothers, for laying eggs, they have to come to fresh waters. So process of laying eggs is spawning. And the process of migration from marine, salt water to fresh water, that is anadromous migration. And after laying eggs, the mothers will die, and the eggs will develop into larval forms. And again, those larval forms will, again, they will come to its native place, that is marine waters. So here the migration from freshwater to marine water is catadromous migration. So this is the most important general characters of this class Cyclostomata. We will see some examples of this class. Petromyzon, its common name is lamprey, and another one is Myxine, its common name is hagfish. These are the two different examples which are present in the class Cyclostomata. This belongs to Aenetha, which do not have the jaw. And now we will come to the superclass fishes, and in that we are having the class Chondrichthys and Ostrichthys. It is divided into broadly two different classes. Those are Chondrichthys and Ostrichthys. Okay, now we will see the classification and what are the different characters, how they are classified, and what are the difference between the animals which are present in between these two classes. Okay, now one by one, these are completely belongs to marine family. These are completely marine. But Ostrichthys fishes are both marine and freshwater. Both marine and freshwater. And here we have to know what is meant by Chondrichthys and what is meant by Ostrichthys. The main difference here, it is there. Its endoskeleton is cartilaginous. Cartilaginous endoskeleton. What is endoskeleton? That means here our endoskeleton is our skeletal system, bones. Hand, in the hand we are having different bones. That is endoskeleton. Our endoskeleton is made up of completely bones, not with cartilage. But here the endoskeleton is made up of cartilage. It is not a bone. It is a soft tissue layer, some tissue like fluids. These are cartilage, but here bony endoskeleton. See, that's why the name here itself indicates Ostrichthys, osteology. Osteo means the study of bones. Osteo means bone. That's why it is containing bones. And Chondrichthys, chondrology, the study of cartilage. That is chondrology. osteology, the study of bones, chondrology, the study of cartilage. So that's why the name had given osteichthyes and chondrichthyes respectively. And here the location of mouth we have to know here. Here the mouth is ventral location. Here mouth is terminal. For example, see here. This is the fish. This is the fish, for example. Here the mouth is ventral. That means, see here. Like this. If you see the shark, the mouth is in ventral position, downside. But mouth is terminal here. Terminal means here it is located. Understand the difference? This is terminal, this is dorsal, this is ventral. So in the chondrichthyes, the mouth is ventral, like this. And here the mouth is terminal. So it's better to draw the diagrams also. Here the notochord is persistent throughout the life, but here the notochord is replaced by vertebral column, because they are having bones, so it is replaced by the backbone. Here they are having gill slits, they are separated and they do not have operculum. What is operculum? Operculum is a layer which will covers the gill slits. So gills cover. Okay, this will help the gills. So this is a layer which will covers the gills. So that is operculum. These are also having, for example, four pairs of gill slits are there. Four pairs of gills, already we know, through which it will helpful in the respiration, process of respiration. So four pairs of gill slits are present and operculum is also there. So operculum is helpful to protect the gills. So it is also known as gill cover. Okay. And here the skin is very tough. The skin is very tough and they are having a placoid type of scales. Placoid scales. There are different types of scales: placoid, ganoid, ctenoid, cycloid. Depend upon the shape, the name is different. Placoid and cycloid. These are having ctenoid or cycloid scales. So this is some anatomy is there. So, different how the serrations are, how the margins are, which rings it is having. So depend upon that, the cycloid and ctenoid, placoid scales are demonstrated. And here the teeth, they are having teeth, and teeth are nothing but modified, because these are toughest scales, placoid scales. Though how the teeth are formed, the placoid scales are modified into teeth. So teeth are modified placoid scales. So these are some of the general characters between these two classes, chondrichthyes and osteichthyes. Now the remaining are, these are having very powerful jaws. But I am mentioning jaw, but I didn't mention whether these are only bony jaws. Powerful jaws, whether the jaw may be powerful, even it is made up of a cartilage. So here the cartilage itself given here the powerful jaw. So this is helpful for the predation purpose, so to hunt. So these are the powerful predators. And here we have to know, these are not having air bladder. Air bladder is nothing but this is a sac-like structure which can store air. So what is the purpose of air bladder here? Ostrichs are having air bladder. So what is the purpose of air bladder here? This will gives you the phenomena of buoyancy. That means it will helpful to float on the surface of water. Even it will not swim, it can float on the water for some time. Because simple, why you are wearing life jacket when you are going on a boat? Because it is filled with the air and it will help you to float on the surface of water. But here the air bladder is absent here, so it cannot float. That's why these fishes always 24/7 they have to swim to protect itself. If it will not swim, it will be sink and it will also die because they don't have air bladders. So it will continuously swim to avoid sinking. But it can float for some time even without swimming also, because they are having air bladder. Air is stored there, so it will reduce the body weight, so automatically it will float. This is the main importance and the difference between these two classes. And the remaining thing is heart. For example, this is a common character for these two. Heart is two-chambered heart. In fishes, two-chambered heart contains, this is a two-chambered heart, for example, contains one auricle and one ventricle. One auricle, this is rough diagrams, is very important. One auricle and one ventricle. And the circulatory system is, as these are higher animals, circulatory system in both of these is closed type. This is present for both, closed type. Okay. And here we have to know, sexes are separate, male and female are separate. Male fish is separate, female is separate. That is also for both. Sexes are separate. Okay. And here, and now the difference is fertilization. Here the fusion of male and female gametes, it is internal. That is, it will inside the body. But here it is external. It will be outside the body. That is in the medium, that is fresh water or marine water. So fertilization is internal here and external there. And some of the some more is there, general characters. So these animals here are viviparous. That means the egg will be hatched inside and the animal itself will be developed inside, and directly they will give birth to young ones, viviparous. But here it will give birth to eggs, that is oviparous. They will lay eggs, ostrichs fishes lays eggs, but they lays directly give birth to young ones. These are viviparous and those are oviparous. And here some more specialties are there in the class Chondrichthyes. That means here some fishes will have electric organs. If you touch that fish, you may feel a sensation of electric shocks. So electric organs are there in which fishes? Example, torpedo. And some fishes have poison sting to protect themselves. All these modifications are to protect themselves from the predator. So that is present in the fish, that is trigon. This is having a poisonous sting. If you suppose to touch that, it will peck you with that Sting. And the reproductive organ here is claspers, present in the males. So how, what is clasper? The pelvic fin modified organ. The pelvic fin is modified into clasper, and is that is a helpful for reproduction. That is called as copulatory organ. Copulatory organ. See here, if this is a fish, this is a fish, front two fins are there and back two fins are there. So front two fins are pectoral fins and back two fins are pelvic fins. Understand? These are the two types of fins. Here the pelvic fins are modified into a copulatory organ, that is clasper. These are the important, these are no other important organs in the osteichthyes. Now we will see the examples of the two classes respectively. Here some very important common names are very important. They may ask in match the following types of questions, very important. Scoliodon. Its common name is dogfish. Second one is Pristis, sawfish. Carcharodon, great white shark. You know, shark that belongs to Chondrichthyes, not belongs to Osteichthyes. Its mouth is present in the ventral side, downside, and it has to continuously swim, otherwise it will also die. If it will not swim, it will be sink in the water. Carcharodon, great white shark, and Trigon. It is having poisonous snake. Its name is stingray. So these are the examples of the class Chondrichthyes. And here coming to Osteichthyes, these are having both marine and freshwater. So we will see some of the examples of marine fishes of this class Osteichthyes. So first one is Exocetus. Its name is, common name is flying fish. Flying fish. And second one is Hippocampus. Hippocampus. Its common name is seahorse. Now freshwater fishes. Some of the freshwater fishes are Labio, its common name is Rohu, Rohu fish, Katla, Katla fish, Clarius, Clarius, its common name is Magur fish, and some common fishes if we are using in the aquariums, aquarium fishes, those are betta. So what is the common name of betta? It is a fighting fish. So for beauty purpose, we will grow these type of fishes in the aquariums. And the next one is pterophyllum. So what is pterophyllum here? Its common name is angel fish. Looking beautiful, that's why it is known as angel fish. See here, Chondrichthyes and Osteichthyes. Chondrichthyes examples are Scoliodon, dogfish, Pristis, sawfish, Carcharodon, great white shark, Trigon, stingray. You may ask that, sir, where is the whale? Whale is not belongs to fish, it belongs to mammals. See here, we will study about whale after this is fishes, and the next class is amphibia, and the next class is reptilia, and the next class is apes, and then finally comes to mammals. Okay, and the examples of the Osteichthyes is marine fishes or Exocetus, that is flying fish, Hippocampus, seahorse, So what is the importance of hippocampus here? Normally we see females will breed and they will lay the eggs. But here in the case of hippocampus, males have brood pouch and they will lay eggs. So this is a exception here. Males are having brood pouch in the case of hippocampus. Okay, and the freshwater fishes are labio, rohu, katla, and clarius, that is magur fish. And for the aquarium purpose, we are using the betta, that is fighting fish, having a good look, and the therophyllum angel fish. Okay, so these are the different classification of the super class fishes, and these are the two classes, chondrichthyes and osteichthyes. So we are completed the fish chapter. Tomorrow we will start amphibians. If you have be prepared for these examples, common names and scientific names, very important. And tomorrow we will discuss about the class amphibia, comes under tetrapods because they are having the four legs. So all the remaining four classes, amphibia, reptilia, birds and mammals, will comes under tetrapods. These are having fins, not true limbs. These are having fins, pectoral fins and pelvic fins. Okay, thank you.